Oh, Greg said first. What's up, Greg? I know, quick draw McGraw.
All right. This is scary.
No.
So here's your bees.
Yeah.
And then here's your this.
Yeah, I don't even know.
So.
Guys, I've never gone live before, so this is all new to me.
So it says live now right here.
Hey, look at that. All right.
So click on it and it'll pull up the feed.
So for those of you who don't know from my channel, this is Erica.
I think you were kind of in there.
I know, I'm half there.
You're good. Okay.
That was fun. Okay. We're going to be doing a couple things today.
I know. She's going to teach me how to not fail at acrylic pours. And also, we're going to do a resin pour.
Yes. Because she's master of that.
Sometimes. Sometimes it works out. Other times you have to just scrape it off and start over. But it's going to be exciting. We're both filming live for each other's channels. So.
Yeah.
We'll both be answering questions. She's got her questions up. I've got my questions
up. Oh, look at that. Oh my gosh. Hey guys. Hey, Sal. Spread the art.
Isn't that great?
I know, right? Hey, Em. Oh my gosh, this is so exciting.
I know. Everybody's like, I love her.
So just so you guys know, I literally just up and drove to Texas.
That happened.
Out of like the blue, and then I called Erica and I was like, so hey, by the way, I'll be in Texas tomorrow.
So, I'm in route.
Yeah, I'm in route. So we decided to do this. So, anywho, hey y'all.
I know.
And yeehaw. Because we are redneck women.
Right?
Alright, so what do you want to start?
Sheila, I did get your package. It's right over there. Those paints are amazing, and we'll open them and look at them for the resin card. Gloves are over there. So, we're both going to be answering our respective feeds. A lot of you guys know the answers to what I'm going to say, so you can answer for each other in the feed if I don't miss it.
There you go. It's 8 o'clock. Thanks. Thanks, Katie. Yeah. Alright, I usually put these on after I've poured my paint in the cup.
Teach me.
You don't really need them before then. Okay. So I brought my pre-mixed paints with me. We were just kind of joking because I brought more art supplies than I brought clothes or toothpaste. So we're each going to do, let's each do a cup. We can, you know what, we could do like a dual pour. I pour half and you pour half. If you want.
I'm sold.
Okay. So, but let's start with this little. We're going to do a little sample on this little one. All these bottles are in the way. Okay, so you get to, long story short, pick whatever colors you want.
I'm going primary because that's what I mess up the least.
And these are all pre-mixed, so go for it. For a canvas this size, you're going to want, I do about half of this cup. This is a 9-ounce cup. So this is a light blue. Oh, you said primary. White, blue, red, yellow. Yeah. And then you want to try the tree ring?
Okay. I can do a tree ring because
tree ring.
But I always mess them up.
Oh, thanks, Gavin.
Okay. I know. If Judy was here, that would be great, but I'll be seeing her tomorrow. So I'm really bad at these kind of pours, so you're gonna have to like for real tell me
for
what's
real
up.
Okay.
Do I have to shake them?
Not really. They're already pretty shaped. Okay. So depending on how many colors you want to use, because realize you need to fill half. So if you're gonna use say like 3 or 4 colors, you kind of just base it off of that. And so this is a good way for you to see how liquidy they are.
Right.
But as you can see, I don't know if they can see that, but it sits on top. See how
right.
It doesn't mix.
It doesn't, okay.
Yeah. So really how much you pour in here depends on how much of whatever colors you want.
Now, I watched people before that like drop their paints in from like a second story building. Does that make a difference?
People do that. That can help create more bubbles, therefore more cells.
That looks so good already. And mine's like,
okay. Well, I will tell you, if you pour like two drops like that, you'll be there for forever.
Okay.
Go
okay.
For it. You know.
Okay. I'm just nervous. Okay.
Don't be. Okay. Good. And then you can also always go back to a color. You know, you're not married to any amount of anything.
Is it better to have just put it all in at one time or to like layer different colors?
I kind of tend to put it all in at one time. Now, one thing too is with the tree ring pour, you don't want as many cells.
That's true.
So I generally, you definitely don't want to pour from two stories high. I mean, maybe pour a little slower in there. But yeah, I'm just gonna go for it, you know, go crazy. Guys, by the way, I got this at Old Navy, this shirt.
It was one of the things that I bought today right now.
No, I bought it a few days ago. Along with that other awesome looks, or kindness looks awesome on your shirt.
Okay. I forgot what mine said.
Gym hair, don't care. Yep.
That's my daily life is gym hair.
Our motto.
Don't care. Judy said, I'll have to speak up because...
A little bit louder?
Yeah.
Guys?
A little bit louder.
Okay. Hey, Lisa. Can everyone hear me on my channel? My feed? Let me know.
But should I add gold to this? I'm scared.
Depends what you want. Do you want like a rainbow?
I don't know. A rainbow with gold can't be horrible. Just a little bit.
Okay, just a little.
Probably too much.
No, you're good.
Okay.
Okay. So you're gonna want a little bit more. So just pick one.
I feel like the yellow is taking over.
It looks like that, but you never know once you start pouring it out. Here, add a little bit more weight on top, and then we'll go ahead and pour it.
So people are asking what the mix is.
Okay, yes, good question. So in here is approximately five parts Floetrol, three parts paint, and two parts water.
So you don't add any silicone?
No, no silicone.
No other coconut oil?
No.
J40.
I've gotten my cells down to the point, or my mixture down to the point where I don't need to do that to get cells. I get like lots of cells as it is. I mean, you can look in the cups and kind of tell. So now is a good point to put on your gloves.
Okay. It always looks better in the cup in my world than it does on the canvas.
Okay. And then I'm going to show you, I'm going to start this and then you're going to finish it. So you take it and you're going to very slowly pour right in the center. I like to go in a little bit of a circle pattern like that. See that?
Yeah.
Okay.
You do that a lot slower than I've seen people do it. Does it matter?
Well, you can tell, I mean, by the rings there. The faster you do it, the less rings you'll get. So to get the more defined rings, yeah, you want to go, there you go, just like that. And you can even, like, kind of move it around a little bit because obviously you've got more paint on this side, so maybe go a little bit that way.
It's all yellow.
But it won't be. Okay, good.
Don't pour it all in.
Oh, my sound is on. Oh, good. I'm loud and clear. Okay, good.
It looks fun in here.
It's a party in a cup. Okay, cool. Let's, So you can either like kind of leave that and uh-huh. Let it like do its thing. I would maybe tilt a little bit just to get your corners covered. And then it's really up to you. I also kind of tend to like to off-center
right.
That part.
This looks so much better than anything I've ever done with acrylics.
It's all in the mixture.
That's what I hear, and then I try the mixture and it's...
Yeah. There you go. And then you can kind of take some excess, you know, and just get the other little spots here covered.
I know, I like the side.
Yeah. And it's going to keep moving. I mean, I'm assuming this table's fairly level.
Yeah, it is. As long as it's not, like, run up on the, the foot pad down there.
Cool. Question. Okay, need to do this on a 26 by 30. Okay, so I'm going to give y'all some math real quick. So just, if you're really bad at math, I'm sorry. And maybe you take a pencil and write it down.
I would have to take notes.
So, basically for every square, for an 8 by 10, I do 5 ounces of paint, which means basically for every 16 square inches, I do 1 ounce of paint, is I think the calculation that I came up to. So, like, for a 16 by 20, it's, I think, about 20 ounces of paint. So... yeah, if you just do for every 16 square inches, 1 ounce of paint is basically how much I do. So I hope that makes sense. And if I had a calculator, I would calculate how much we need for 26 by 30, but I don't have a calculator right now. So, there you go.
I just had to show the people that I didn't mess up an acrylic pour.
Yeah.
Because they know my struggles.
Well aware. Okay, I'm gonna put this one in the rack.
Yeah. And then we could put this canvas on there or whatever.
Yeah. Y'all, I did mess it up. Then again, it's not in the thing yet, so
don't drop it. Oh my goodness, this is so fun. Oh, I'm sorry, Betty.
Do we need another rack?
Well, do we need one for the resin? Or what are we doing here?
We're going to do the half and half one, right?
Yeah. So let's just take this canvas off. I'll put it right here for you. Get rid of the nuts, should be that. Okay. So I've got my colors here. This is a 12 by 24 canvas. Do you want a clean cup or do you want to use that one again?
I don't mind using
this. You can have a clean cup. Okay. So I have purples and blues in here and black. So if you want to maybe do a lighter side or whatever, you can really do anything and it will look awesome, I'm sure.
Do not count 100% on that.
Challenge accepted.
Exactly. I'm so good at messing stuff up.
Yeah.
It's a talent that I have.
So for this, I would fill it actually more about 3/4 full. I actually need to put a little bit. So fill your cup about 3/4 full. I know math is maybe not the funnest thing in the world, but it's once y'all get used to it, then you'll be able to just do it by sight. You won't really have to sit there and figure it out. When you're doing the larger canvases, though, you really do want to do a little bit of math. Otherwise, you guarantee you'll always end up with not enough paint in there every time.
Do you find that the metallics react different than the not metallics?
Absolutely. And it really depends on the brand. It depends on the color even. Like silver, I've noticed, totally takes over, whereas gold doesn't. And gold, it really depends on also where you put it in the cup. Sometimes gold completely hides, it disappears.
Right.
And then I have this Deco Art Metallics, the antique bronze. That one takes over every single time. I have to be very careful with that one. It's dangerous. So.
That's really interesting because I find in resin pours that gold usually takes over.
Oh, how funny. Yeah. But like I said, it depends on where you put it in the cup as well. depending on where you, how much, how dominating you want to do. If you put it in the middle of the cup, it's gonna kind of just peek through a bit. So
that looks better than any pour I've ever done, and I'm scared though because it's not gonna turn out that way.
Okay, so since we're doing two cups here, what we can do is we can either flip it or we can do two treatment pours.
Which do you prefer? Which looks nicer in the end? Another
tough question.
Yeah.
Let's tree ring pour this because that's just my favorite. So yeah. I'll go do yours about there. I'm going to do mine about here.
Okay.
So I'll just pour right in the middle there.
Yours is coming out way smoother than mine is. I can tell that you do this quite often.
I have done this a couple times before. Not many, but a couple.
I was like, you're a liar. This is your channel.
My purple. Okay. Save a little bit at the end of your cup.
Yours looks so good.
But our colors are gonna go really well together. So can y'all see that? I think so. Okay. So we're gonna go ahead and move this around. And we're giving, we're gonna have the option here to add more paint as needed.
Mm-hmm.
But one thing I like to do when I'm doing two separate color palettes a bit, because I do these with my daughter, and we'll each pick our own colors. Oh, one thing I should mention is whatever side I like the best is generally the side I will go towards first. So like I really like this side, I'm gonna go towards that because that's gonna end up being the most stretched out.
Right.
Okay, so we have that so far. Let's turn this around. Hope everyone can see that. Now we have the issue of if we stretch it much more that way to cover the whole thing, we're gonna run out of paint and we're gonna end up stretching a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So let's go ahead and take the rest. Now this is your side and that's my side, so we're gonna cross over here and go ahead and fill in some over here with like some ribbons. Oh, there's your yellow.
I know, I found it.
It's like, where did it go? Cool beans. Okay. Okay, so now.
It looks like that was a totally different cup.
It does, this. Actually. But that's okay.
Yep.
Nobody saw that.
There will be playback, and I will get called on it.
Okay.
She is a pro.
So let's go ahead and we're going to bring it back a little bit this way.
Y'all, if I were to try to do this by myself, it would look like the outside of this bottle.
So there you go. I mean, that's fun, you know?
Although,
I'm going to do one thing.
Go for it.
This is going to probably bug me. Just this one part doesn't quite like. So,
do you want the yellow?
I'm gonna just put one little like stripe through. I think I have enough left.
They quit right when you got to that.
Right?
Now, you don't torch or do.
Oh, you totally can. I didn't bring my torch. Mainly because I hope my roommate's watching this, but he got the idea to super glue it open.
Super glue it open.
So that you don't have to clip the little thing.
Yeah.
To anyways. So yeah, long story short, he broke it.
I had a torch.
But I will say with tree ring pours specifically, I generally don't torch it because that will bring up extra cells. But we already got a lot of cells here, and it looks pretty cool.
Yeah.
So,
I was just mainly asking for
You're not gonna have the issues like in resin where you get the air bubbles and
right.
you have to worry about it. The air bubbles will go away by themselves. Literally, like the only reason to torch when you're doing a pour is to help create some. Pretty much.
Personally, I'm not a fan of like cells overtaking a piece. Like in my head, it gets too busy.
Yeah. Yeah, interesting. So,
I think that was really good.
Yeah, there we go.
Ta-da! I think your side looks amazing.
It's
and mine looks like, I knew I shouldn't have used that much yellow.
It's exciting.
See? I gotta say, that's my best, something.
Pour.
Yes, acrylic pour. Me and words, we don't get along some days.
Okay, now this is a perfect learning opportunity real quick for my guys, because one of my commonest questions is how do I get my leftover paint? So I'm gonna show you. I have two cups here. Here's what I do, watch this magic. I put one on top of the other, and then I leave it. That's what I do. Then I'll come back in like a week or two, and I'll reuse this paint. That's literally all I do.
That's bananas.
Yeah, so if just leaving it like this for weeks, for even a month or two, will be totally fine. It won't dry out. It won't get whatever.
And that's like even with your medium in it and everything, it doesn't.
Yeah, it's totally fine. So I just keep doing that. The next pour I do, I'll have another cup. So I'll take this one after it's drained and I'll put the next cup on top and leave it. And I just keep doing that until I have a cup with enough paint in it to do a pour.
So when I was a bartender, we would call it like bar mat shots. If someone was like, I want a shot, but I don't know what. So I would pick up the bar mat that I've been pouring shots in all night and it'd be like overflowing with everything. And I'm like, here you go. So that's kind of like what this is going to be.
Yeah.
It's going to be like a suicide.
Yeah, you never know what it is.
That's amazing.
Yeah, Megan and Janet, I did actually answer that earlier, but that's okay. I do 5 parts Floetrol, 3 parts paint, and 2 parts water. And there you go. And if anyone still missed that, I can put it in the description later. Obviously, it's live now, so I don't really know how that works. First live video, guys.
It's going to go live, and then you just log in and
edit.
Yeah, so you just edit it
as normal.
Okay. I totally hate it this way.
Did, but that's fine. Because I'm messing anyways. That's just a fact of life with this kind of artwork editing.
Yeah.
What colors do you want to do on your?
Ooh, okay. My favorite to do are really like blues, but kind of like turquoisey teals, and then bronzes and golds and stuff like that. I think that's my favorite. I also really like purples and blues and those together.
Gotcha.
Whatever color this is,
which one?
I don't know. It's stuck to the table. It's like a teal.
Oh, yeah.
And here are the infamous sticks.
Yes.
Yes.
So
great to see them in person, guys.
I don't think I have a bronze, but here's a gold. This teal's good.
Oh my gosh, David is watching. David, I totally just told on you for breaking my torch. Did you fix it?
You got ratted out, dude.
Yeah, you totally got ratted out. Then my roommate's watching. Okay. Oh, this is so exciting. All
right, now we're gonna do some resin. So I brought a gold, teal. This color is this color.
Okay.
Purple and white.
Cool.
Okay.
I'm gonna do a little some more.
Do you wanna do lips?
Sorry.
So
I need a, you're tardy for the party. They're talking about mixing for acrylic pours, and they're going to end up asking me questions. I'm going to be like,
okay. Yeah, guys, if you have any questions, you can certainly ask me. You know, but Erica just loves it when you text her all day with all your questions.
It's true.
About acrylic pours. It's her favorite thing.
It is. I can answer all of them.
Ever.
Actually, just call me.
That's called sarcasm. Oh, good. David got me a new one. Okay.
Or going to.
What's a G plus? Oh, like Google Plus?
I don't know. Google Plus is something you have to have for, like, everything now. Like, you have a Google Plus account since you have a YouTube account.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I have, like, 10 Google Pluses. I just don't know anyone actually, like, uses it. I mean, I know they're trying to kind of make it like Facebook. But
I know, they're trying to make it a thing. It's not really a thing. So.
Hi, Dad.
Your dad's on there?
Hi, Dad.
Hi, Dad.
He's my favorite.
Alright, so we prepped this canvas before the video. You guys know my process.
Okay, Shammy, in his defense though, he also bought me the torch in the first place, but he just bought me a new one. So, anyways, okay.
It's good. It's
let's do some resin. I'm very excited.
Partner, resin. Okay. I wish I could tell you, like, numbers, but I wing it. At this point.
So it's 1-to-1,
right?
Yeah. So for the guys on my channel who didn't see me mix the resin before, this is art resin. It is 1-to-1 ratio. So that's pretty simple. You know, however much you're mixing up, it's just 1-to-1 hardener and resin. So
we're just gonna go with like a little over 8 ounces. You may just have to reload your screen's frozen, but I don't think it matters. I think your feed's still live.
Live stream offline.
Huh, there it goes. Like your text feed is still going. It has, it's not.
Oh, YouTube stopped. It says.
Say okay. Say.
It said open app again.
Yeah.
Live.
Now go to the this thing again.
Will that start a new one?
No.
Oh, resume. Okay.
Nope.
Not.
Time out. Too close.
Okay. Sorry, guys.
Oh, someone just admitted this start. So really. Okay, sorry, guys. It just froze. Yes, we're right back. Hey, Pamela. Welcome.
I hope you guys are like doing well answering all the questions of all the people. John, there's no strippers.
Oh, there is.
I know. And
I invited a couple. Damn it. But they're gonna be here later. The ATD after dark.
The ATD after dark
show. Yeah. That's later. Okay.
We're making good time. Already a pour down and
yeah, see. MKB is smart. She's watching both streams. So mine went down for a second, but she didn't lose a beat.
Oh.
She's watching both.
How do you watch both?
You just use 2 tabs.
Oh, that makes sense. Yeah. Blonde.
I just had extreme amounts of coffee today.
I did not. I took a nap.
Like an adult.
I'm bad at adulting.
Okay, so the resin, you want to, I mean, your guys already know, but yeah, you're going to really, really thoroughly mix it for several minutes. You have to scrape the sides, the bottom, and everything, because if it doesn't mix properly, it won't harden and cure properly, and that sucks.
It's the worst day.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you do a piece, and you're like, nailed it! And then the next day, you're like,
not so much.
Yes.
Unnailed. Still sticky or has pits, maybe, or different things can happen.
so many.
So yeah, you want to make sure your ratio is correct, that you have the 50-50, and that you mix it super duper well. Very important with the resin. And I will probably do a video on that later. It's on my list, guys.
I keep a to-do list too. That whiteboard over there is like ideas.
Oh wow, I'm not that organized. Yeah,
I can't remember the last time I read it. So I mean,
yeah, someone's commenting on how your area is so organized. Mine looks not at all like this, which is why you only see my hands.
Oh, it's just in this.
Yeah,
area.
You only see straight down because my, it's like a tornado hit.
I want to figure out how to do like camera in camera so I can do like this angle and like.
And then the direct.
Yeah. I don't have that kind of programming. I don't even know what it would take. I'm sure it costs dollars. Okay. Unnailed it, e-science. This is true. This is very true. Anytime I make up a word, they're like, e-science. That's not a real thing.
Not a real word.
Okay. So
we've got our resin all mixed up.
Yes. Usually art resin doesn't have those little bubbles that like fly out, but this one decided to be different.
Of course.
So I didn't know how many of the colors you wanted to use, but
I generally think simple is best. Maybe like
same.
Four, I think, is usually pretty good in here. But is this, what was this? Like a pearl?
It's white. It's white? Just regular white.
Yeah, it's just white.
So this is a powder. It's a pigment powder. And you mix it in resin, it turns into an awesome metallic color.
Cool.
These are all for epoxy paste. And for people that love to get cells and have a problem doing it with resin, that's the stuff you need. Because it's an epoxy paste.
I'm gonna take these up so everyone can see. Looks. Alright. So, there you go. Epoxy pigment. This is teal. And then we've got bright gold. There we go. On the resin, can I put regular acrylic paint? Yeah, you totally can.
With what kind of paint you use, I think the important thing to think about is what you're wanting in your piece. Like if you want something transparent, use an ink. If you want cells, use a paste. If you want just color without any effect, you can use acrylic.
Good to know.
Ultimately, what you use depends on what you're going for.
Yeah, because they all have different effects.
Right.
Yeah.
So.
Cool beans.
This is all of it. I usually will put like a clear coat down so that the resin flows easily, more easily over the surface.
Yes.
But this is your piece, so I'm gonna
help. Oh no, now I'm so under pressure.
Don't be under pressure.
I'm nervous, okay?
Don't be nervous.
Okay.
You got all right,
what are we doing? What are we doing? I just go for it.
You go for it.
Okay. So the ratio, this is 10 to 1, right?
10% is the general rule.
Now, how do you generally just take?
Yeah, I usually put the resin in first because that'll give me like an idea of how much
of that you'll need.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I'm very nervous, guys. It's like
Rod, the epoxy paste is more likely to give you cells because it's like. Is Jeff on? He is. Jeff's in the house. The boyfriend's on. He's logged on from a bachelor party in Austin.
Cool. All right, so.
Yep.
You just eye it, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Just like, okay. All right.
My guys know that, like, me and Matt, we're not real tight.
Yeah.
Like, I usually just eyeball it and hope for the best.
Yeah.
And if it doesn't work out, I almost always over make resin And then whatever leftover I have, I'll make coasters.
Yeah.
Like, I'll find something to do with it.
Yeah. You never want to waste.
Especially not resin.
Yeah. And just take a little extra canvas. Oh my gosh, this is exciting. Okay, so this is...
Rod, I don't know if that epoxy, like Cast and Craft, is considered a paste, but it does work. That's a little bit of a long way with that gold.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Because it's like super thick.
Yeah. Okay. Turn to center. Okay, no pressure, no pressure.
No pressure, no whammies. I believe in you, just like you believed in me and my ring pour.
Don't be nervous.
Oh, I have a troll?
You have a troll?
I don't know. Someone said that.
Who's on here that, what's up, Ideas? I see you.
Roland.
Who's somewhere on here that, like, you trust to be a moderator?
Well, my dad.
Where is your dad?
Dad, are you still on there? Because you could be my moderator. Let's see. I don't know, though. I don't see any trolls on it.
Okay.
You know where I go? Oh, Dad. Okay.
Okay. So click on that. Yeah.
All right, Dad, you're going to become a VIP here.
Add moderator. So now he can block people, delete comments.
Cool. Okay, Jenna, a troll is someone that, like, just kind of goes around and spreads nastiness, pretty much. Let's just put it that way. So, yeah, Dad, you can block or delete comments if you need to. I trust you. All right. So I'm going to keep my mixing here. Okay, so this is a powder. I didn't see anything, but I'm not really, you know, paying attention, so.
I get trolls on live feeds every once in a while. There's a guy called Stinky Feet that comes in or something like that, and is all the time like, who has the best smelling feet? And like goes on rants and like, can I get a little bit of help?
Cool, okay. And then this one is which?
That is Purple Rain.
Purple Rain.
And it is one of my favorite, it's a deep, deep, like this is Purple Rain.
Oh wow, okay.
But it thins out like when you tilt it to like a really deep violet. I don't even have any pieces, most of my Purple Rain pieces though.
Yeah, really quickly. Is this what you used online?
Yes, I did.
See, okay, we're good. All right, you know what, we're probably gonna do all five here.
Brad said having these two together is like having chocolate and peanut butter. It's gotta be, it's like the Reese's.
Yeah.
It's bananas is all I would say about that.
Okay. So this can just come right out, right?
Where is Mixed Media from? She's from California.
I'm from Los Angeles, y'all.
She lives in like the big city.
I'm from the valley, to be honest.
The valley,
like, you know, 90210, I'm from the valley. I literally am a valley girl. Yes. Jealous. All right.
Justine went to Larez and Artisu is officially broke. Thank you, David.
Okay. Last color we're mixing up, and then we're going to kind of go for it. All right, now this is thick.
Yes.
So this is the paste.
Yes.
So do you need less of this?
The paste goes a long way.
Now, I don't also mind if this is translucent because it's white.
Right.
So I think I'm just going to do just a little. Or would you recommend doing more than that?
It's still going to be opaque.
Okay. That's fine. It looks good.
I would have brought over some translucent ones. Like, I have a lot of inks.
And I do have extra in here, so
I'm just gonna pour it for you.
Yeah.
A lot of times what I'll do before I even start mixing my resin is I'll spray paint the base. So yeah. Because it's gonna gap. I mean, like on the sides that it goes down, and you can't, it's hard to like pick up. There's enough in there if you want to make more of a color. It's harder to like pick up what's on the table. But I usually will go back and sand the sides if I need to and make it look.
Yeah, she actually finishes her paintings and makes them all pretty, unlike me. I just ship them out. I'm like, you get what you get. I don't know.
No one's going to see the back.
I think it's like war wounds, kind of, you know? But
well, a lot of
with
people
the resin, like, I think it would definitely look better finishing it off the back.
A lot of people are like, why don't you ever like finish the sides? I'm like, because it's organic. It looks not like a print.
Yeah. All right. We're going to use our heat gun here to get rid of the air bubbles on the clear coat. Okay, I will do more lines.
I love it.
Yeah. I just was nervous.
Hey, Karen.
Oh, okay.
You didn't. I did a ring pour with acrylics, and guess what? It was not mud.
No, it was awesome.
I'll show y'all at the end of this.
Okay.
Did you prep the red?
No.
I whispered that so that your channel can stay PG.
That's okay. You can say damn it.
That's it.
It's a lemon.
That one's a good one.
Yes, Missy, you can ask me your questions and I will do my best to answer.
I usually tell the people when I'm on live to put questions in all caps so I don't miss them.
Yeah. And for anyone who doesn't know on my channel yet, ATD is Artist Till Death. So go ahead and look that up and subscribe immediately.
Right now.
Also, but in a new tab so that you don't lose your feed.
Right. I think everybody in my feed knows. I think they're like all cross-subscribed.
Probably.
Because when I like checked yours for your troll, like you're half like, people are like, I see all of you.
Right? Oh, someone wants to be our assistant. You can be our assistant.
I know. We're looking for an intern.
Yeah. But you're going to have to be willing to travel between Los Angeles and Dallas and then potentially like Canada and Europe.
Right,
you know,
all the things.
Horrible job.
Right.
Very rough. Okay, now what?
So you can do pours with resin very similarly to how you do them with acrylics. The differences are you don't mix a medium. The medium is the resin.
Yeah.
And you have to use heat because it pops the bubbles.
Right, yeah.
You can do flip cups. You could do ring pours. You could do string pulls. You do the bottle bottom things. All the things you can do with acrylics, you can do with resin.
Okay.
So if your favorite is a ring pour, I can get you a cup. If you want to do like a puddle pour, it works.
Okay, so here is a person that should be blocked. So remove, right?
That'll just remove the comment. You need to hide them from your channel.
Okay.
Yeah.
There we go. I just hid my first trophy.
Okay, cool. Now they're probably going to pop in line.
Yeah, this is kind of the problem with doing a crossover here.
But I have a few people set up as moderators, so in case someone's absent.
Yeah, she's like all over this. All right. Here we go. So I'm going to wing this. I'm going to kind of take what I have learned from watching all the Artist Till Death videos. And we're going to attempt. I'm so nervous.
Don't be nervous.
This is either going to be like disgusting or it's going to be amazing. You know what? It's going to be amazing.
That's exactly the mindset. It's going to be the most brilliant pour.
It will. It's going to be like, what? You haven't done 100 resin paintings before?
Right.
I swear, my head's really not that big.
So people are like, no sippy sippies?
No, yeah.
Yeah, I didn't want to like
falling down on the job.
Pollute your channel with drinking debauchery.
No. Okay, So this is a metallic teal?
Yeah, that's the powder.
The powder, right.
Yeah.
So that one's a bit translucent.
Yeah.
And
you can always add more if you want to make it more opaque.
I honestly don't know how resin works, but with paint, I tend to add a bit of white, which can help blend. So with that blue, I'm definitely going a lot slower than probably normal.
Well, the thing is, art resin has one of the longest open times.
Right, it's about 45 minutes, right?
I've worked from
an hour
into an hour.
Okay.
And further.
All right, so let's go ahead and we're going to heat gun this and move it around. Yeah.
We're trying to give you a longer,
a lower setting, right?
I almost always heat mine on low, but you can definitely kick it up.
Cool. This is so exciting. Okay.
Basically, heating the epoxy paste and letting it run over the other colors is what will generate the cells and down. There you go. This is where I got my tattoo from.
Oh, wow, look at that. Cool. Okay, so far so good. Can you see the end of it?
I don't know if closed captioning is a thing on live feeds.
Okay. What do you think so far? Are we good?
Yeah, I was just watching all these little cells pop up.
Yeah, I hear lots of cells. I don't even know. Okay.
Now gold is a color that will
take over.
Take over.
Yeah. I'm gonna kind of layer this, guys. Do I need to pour maybe slower or faster to not get those? I don't know, I actually kind of like that design.
I like those little swirlies, but
I got some little swirlies in there, I think because I'm pouring too little,
too fast.
But that's okay. You know what? Like I said, it's going to be awesome.
It is. These are really interesting. The thing about resin is, you can only control it so much. It's that kid in Walmart that you told couldn't get Skittles today,
so
and it is on the floor having a stroke.
Okay, I'm gonna cross over with this. So this is a teal. Okay, let me go back to my heat gun.
I like that crossover.
Yeah. Okay. I'm taking this so slow. I'm sorry for any impatient people. Why are you heating every so many colors and not at the end? Because I'm using the heat gun to blend the colors as I go, basically. I don't think there's a particularly right or wrong with that. I think you could kind of do either.
Everybody's like, you're doing so great.
Oh,
you're doing good so far.
Okay. Look at these little lines. I can't help but get these lines. Okay, that's okay. I just need to pour more.
Yeah.
Is it? Yeah. I'm just so nervous, so I'm going slow, guys. I'm sorry.
Don't apologize. It's all a learning curve.
Alright, we're gonna go back to our curve.
Alright.
Someone apparently on the floor above just dropped a marble.
That happens all the time.
Okay. Now you don't have to just use the heat gun to move around. You can just kind of move it around, right?
You can just tilt it.
The heat helps.
Bends it out so that it's like more fluid.
Yeah, I think that's something I could have done a little better in my other paintings too, is use more heat. Alright, let's do it.
It's easier with like two people. That way you have someone like holding it for the tilts and.
Yeah. Okay. Alright, what do we think so far? It's looking good?
Mm-hmm.
Where did your question go? Oh, the heat gun will make it set slightly faster. I don't think it's fast enough that you have to worry about it, unless you're moving super slow like I am. Just kidding. Yeah.
Everybody's like, super tilt!
Super tilt.
Super tilt's something Jeff does when he's like, let's be extra.
Okay. Yeah, we're definitely gonna have some leftover.
Perfectly fine.
But I like these colors better. Alright. So I'm gonna kind of finish off these edges a bit.
You can also like blow on them after you thin them out. Love the color combo. Do not super tilt.
Okay.
We made 8 ounces. The teal is by Artisu. The color is teal.
Put a little more paint on here, and then we're gonna go ahead and torch again and see what we've got.
Everybody's like, blow! And other people are like, don't blow!
Don't blow, believe it, it's crap magic. Okay. I'm like super purple fan, so I just wanna get a bit more of this in here.
I love that you like have a definite direction, like obvious, and then you're like, I love that because it's like too, you know, sometimes it's just too much in one direction, and you're like, I need something that's like out of the blue opposite. I need something that's this way.
Asymmetrical and whatnot. Okay. Could you add alcohol to the top of this for another layered effect?
You can. And we can do that if you want to get crazy. The thing about adding alcohol is it's almost guaranteed to give you pitting.
That's a good question. Yeah, because I added some alcohol and I did get a little bit of pitting, but not bad. But maybe that's why. I didn't mind it.
Y'all, Sheila Jones sent me some awesome new colors. And a long note that I will read later. How great are these? It makes me want to do an earth tone. All right, I'm going to get back to helping.
I got this. I have two arms, you know.
I'm a mother, so that's like having 10 arms.
Definitely multitasker, okay, people?
Yeah.
You can also like blow it.
Yeah,
like that.
All right, guys, we're gonna we'll do a blowing in just a second.
Like you're about to like pull out some awesome lacing.
Yeah. Here. Oh my goodness, this is so fun, guys.
If you end up with a better piece than I've ever done, we're literally can't be friends anymore.
No.
Also, I'm coming over.
Yeah. Just gonna have to come crush my garage.
Right? Rod, I am not sure what brand they are.
And guys, I'll go back to your questions in just a second, I promise.
It says HNC. I'm not sure. I can't remember what that stands for. Sheila, what does the HNC stand for? Also, congrats on your commission.
Ooh, those are looking real nice. Okay, what do we think? What do we think? I kind of do maybe want to blow a little bit there.
Go for it. I'll get out of here.
All right, here we go. Don't mess it up.
Upside of fibromyalgia is to be up at 5 a.m. to watch ATV after dark. B, if you're drunk, you're not allowed to message. You're in timeout. Karen will put you in timeout.
Oh, thank you, Dad. You're good.
That looks amazing.
I know, right? I don't know. I think we're happy with it. Are you happy with it?
I'm down. Yeah, everything that you got going on here. This like wispy stuff is awesome.
Yeah, I got some killer cells.
That's super unique to your like doily pore because it was like this.
Yeah.
So that's what gave you those.
I have lots of cells and lacing.
But okay. It's kind of like overdone with like cells and stuff.
Do you guys want to see a close up? Let me know. Super lightheaded. Yeah, I'm a pro. This glowing stuff. I know that sounds bad. Okay. Now I do have a little pitting here, it looks like.
Yes. So I would just drop some purple just into that spot. You can use like the tip of the stir stick. Okay. I know.
Be very too long to my parents.
Well, it's a good person to be married to.
Yeah, right. Instead of someone else's husband, that'd be weird.
I have these things somewhere.
So I told him, was like, you guys want to see a close up, and I didn't even listen to your answers.
Rejected all of your answers, and I'm just going to play a little bit.
And then I kind of ignored you.
So I have these like silicone combs
that
I started using to like whoosh. Because I did do that one time, and I was like, that's so fun. And then I did these, and now I'm like, I forget that I have them.
Yeah.
I think it looks good.
Okay. I think I'm going to leave it, you know, because you can overwork things. And then I can. Okay.
Trying to figure out if you've got enough. I'm going to move that over to the area.
Okay, well, let's do this close-up real quick.
Okay.
So I'm going to take my gloves off because otherwise I think I'm going to get... Yeah, there is less glitter on hers. right, guys, hold on. It's gonna shake for a second. Unavoidable, I guess. All right, guys. I forget what size this is. I think a 10 by 20.
I think you're right.
Canvas, and it's the gallery. Okay. So like here's this really cool cells and lacing over here. And a cool wispiness. Cool, green, and purple. Oh my gosh, so much fun. Yeah, there you go. I hope you guys like it. I'm learning from the best over here. And if you come to Texas, she'll teach all of you. I'm just kidding.
I will. I have a class on June 2nd.
There you go. She has a class on June 2nd. Let's see if there's no glitter, but there's gold.
The gold is really sparkly.
Like really kind of glittery. I'm trying to fix. Is that better on the glare, guys? Let me know. Oh my God, can you mail that to me? It matches. Sure.
So all the people, I'm like, it's all for sale.
Yep, everything's for sale.
I'm trying to figure out if you have enough for like.
Yeah, we totally have enough for that.
All right, I'm gonna switch out.
Okay. How do you really touch your phone and not get resin all over? Oh, because you didn't do resin thing yet, huh?
Nope.
I was like, I have resin all over my glove.
Magic.
Magic.
I'm gonna have to mail you a box of gloves.
Nah.
I've used three. This is my third pair, guys. I go through them.
Messier or what? That's a really good question, Missy.
Yeah, and Kimberly, I'll make sure we get the products in there. Tara, how much does resin cost? It really depends on what kind of resin you get. Art resin for a gallon is, I think, about $100 for a gallon of resin. But it depends. You can get, like, at Michael's or Hobby Lobby, you can get, like, Envirotex with their, like, coupon.
Yeah.
It's, like, $20 for 32 ounces.
Yeah, it just depends on what you want to do, guys, because the art resin, it has a much higher working time, which is one of the benefits of it, but... Anyway, so just, you know, you can research the different resins and the benefits of them. Missy, that's a good question. I still don't know how much.
What?
She's asking me how much it is.
Oh. What?
I don't know. Can you message me? Message me after this.
For the resin?
No, for the painting. Yeah, if you can message me on either my Facebook page or Instagram, or email me info@thepainterinyou.com, we'll figure something out. We'll get that to you. This is art resin. Can you see it?
People are like, oh, Judy said art resin is $1.19 a gallon direct from them online. Oh. Nurse calls. What's your question? I'm here for you. Oh, she wanted to ask Greg a question? Let's do a resin dirty pour tree ring. There's a lot happening.
Do we have enough to do that?
I
don't know. She's the pro. I'm gonna leave that up to her. I guess I couldn't be fine if there's negative space, huh?
Yeah. Give it a shot.
Roll with it. Okay. My computer. Well, I don't know what happened. All right. So we have
a flip cup.
A flip cup. Well, guys, you gotta make
it. Oh, thanks, Greg.
Moment of time here. Okay. So we gotta think in terms of like light and dark and what we would want to mix.
Mhm.
So I'm gonna start with purple and gold here.
But the thing about resin is, it's because of its consistency and viscosity and the science in it.
Yeah, it won't mix.
It doesn't, like with acrylics, you have to, like, consider.
Let me rephrase it. I mean, more like what colors I want to be next to each other.
If you thin it enough, it will mix and it will turn into
bleh. Yeah. Okay.
And sorry guys, on my side, I hope my stream is still up. My computer went off, so I can't see your comments for the moment.
Your stream is still live.
Okay, so I will fix my computer in just a second. I may simply need to plug it into a charger. I don't know. It didn't give me the warning that your battery was about to die. But I don't know. I'll fix it in a second.
So all of you Mixmedia gals, people, I will give her a list of all the products that we used, and she can link it in the description box so that you,
yeah, I'll make
you
sure
don't have
you
to
guys
wonder.
All have everything, all the products used. This is gonna be crazy.
I know. I really like how it looks in the cup right now.
Even I haven't done this before, you know.
Does the resin give you a high like spray paint can? Nick.
And here's what I'm gonna do on the cups that I'm done with. I'm gonna flip them over on here, just so we kind of use everything.
Mm-hmm.
That cup needs to be cut down. I know it is. It is a bit long. Grab some scissors.
Doesn't she do? Oh, I'm fighting the urge here.
Just go with it.
That's also what she said.
Oh, I missed that one.
Yeah. Okay. So we've got a couple more. Do you want to go for it or wait?
Ready to get crummery. I can link that for you. I think I have it linked in some of my other videos if you look in the description box. You can get it off Amazon or Promarines. Promarines.
Promarine
website.
I can't. I totally heard Pro Murray. I was a little confused.
Okay. We're so glad you tuned in, Amanda. Promarine's working time is about the same as Envirotech's. It's like 30, 45 minutes, depending on how hot it is in your space. Ideally for, oh my God, I'm scared. Okay.
I'm gonna resin my computer. Okay. I get the chair.
You got time. No rush. Y'all, I think I got her super into doing lives now. Maybe she'll start.
Yeah. You guys might be stuck with a bunch of live videos now. Where's a good place to plug this in?
That's where she
is. Okay. Okay. I don't know if this is, in fact, the issue. Because like I said, it didn't give me any warning.
Maybe it just...
Oh, that it does.
Okay.
All right.
Fantastic. Answer.
All right. Luckily, my phone was fully charged. Okay, good. Are we still live on here?
We should be. What's it say?
I don't know if I can't see the comments. Does that mean it's not?
Oh, no, no, it is.
Feeding?
It just means no one's saying anything at that moment.
No one's saying anything. What? So, oh, there we go. Okay.
If you, like, touch it and scroll, then it'll pop back up.
Okay, good. All right. Woo! Okay, good.
Yeah, if it wasn't live anymore, it just wouldn't be there. Like, okay. The video would be cut.
Here's a good question. If you're not using acrylics, do you not have to put your colors in any particular kind of order when you're going to do, like, a flip cup or something like that?
Well, if she's asking about if you're not doing acrylics, as in if you're not doing just an acrylic pour, like, if you're doing a resin pour as opposed to an acrylic pour, it really doesn't matter.
Okay.
It comes down to what colors you want to see next to each other. You don't have to really stress about if this color and this color mixes. Is it going to make mud? Is it going to be pretty color? It's really not a concern. It just comes down to, will I like them if I swatched it
together?
I do a lot of swatches before I do a pour just to see if I do like the colors next to each other.
Okay. That's a good question. And Missy and anyone else that missed it, the email is info@thepainterinyou. That's my email. So, and yes, we will put all materials in the description. Okay. Do you want to try to do this now that you're like a pro at German?
Negative.
Negative. Okay. This is exciting. This is definitely a first for me. Alright, give that a minute. Let's do this because it's exciting. Right. Have you done this before? A true room with resin?
I have, and it didn't
work out.
It just wasn't my favorite result, but that is completely because I'm horrible. A true ring, so.
Alright. This is okay. I'm very nervous. Alright, let's do it.
That looks so good in there.
So far, so good.
Mm-hmm.
And guys, I'll have my computer back up in just a second to be answering your questions.
That purple and the gold next to each other are kind of bananas.
Yeah.
The thing about doing a true ring pour, if you don't want cells, we kind of use the wrong paint to avoid cells because so many of them were pigment paste, which tend to sell.
I think it's okay. You love how I put my finger there to avoid the dripping, and then I just stuck my finger right in the resin.
I don't know, you nailed it.
Crushed it.
So nailed it.
Finished it like a cheesecake. Okay. Sorry guys, this is really my first time, so technical issues.
I like to make sure that there's resin, like at least a little bit, even if it's gonna get.
No one saw that.
Everybody saw it.
Nobody saw it.
Oh, yeah. All the people saw.
I could not get it. It's a good thing, like, you probably can't see color wise as good as it is because my face is bright red right now.
I think everybody zoomed in on, like, before, so nobody saw embarrassment face.
Okay, good.
All right.
So
resin's gonna tend to go where there's already like a trail of resin, kind of like if you do watercolor.
Right.
It's gonna follow that. So.
Yeah, it's the same thing with the acrylic paint too. So I will bring it out to the edges.
Mm-hmm.
Especially if it's maybe not like as much paint as normal, and that way it has something to follow.
Right.
To the edges.
Right. So I'm kind of like. Just adding.
No, it's good. Because then you can do that while you're just back.
I'm
yeah. Trying to go faster.
No, it's fine.
Sorry.
My live streamers are used to like me being on here until like we've gone till like midnight before. We've gone 4 hours.
I know, but like this is my first time and I was like it's you know, I gotta be perfect and epic. And, well, you know. Ain't nobody perfect.
Nope.
Okay.
Making it work with what you got is kind of one of the mottos on my channel.
Yeah. It's definitely my special thing. Alright, I gotta be careful with stuff I dig off the table because I've got other stuff in there.
Yeah, just a couple drops of. I think we're covered now, though. I think we got it all.
Okay.
Except for this large drop spot.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay. So guys, I'm sorry. I haven't gotten the comments back up yet. We're gonna do this. Oh my god, that's so good. There's something in there.
Right here.
Oh Jesus. Yeah. Right in the middle.
No, it would be.
Well, there you go. Okay. Good news on that because I totally will not. Well, maybe after I took it. Okay, can you guys all see that? I hope so.
I don't know if you can or not, but we're gonna go with it.
Yeah. I'm sorry, guys. I will get better at this live thing.
You watch your hair. I know. I got resin in my hair like 2 days ago.
A million times?
Oh. Well,
just 2 days ago?
2 days ago, I got enough of it that I was like, I'm gonna have to cut my hair. Thanks for the heads up, Karen. Good looking out. People are like, add the fire, heat it.
Yeah, I think we need to, right?
Ian KB said, tell Marcy to fix her stream. People are like logging into mine to like, holla.
I'm sorry, guys.
How do I switch around? Okay, there it goes. Wife Life 93, it does not smell depending on what brand of resin you use.
Yeah, because the art resin, that's another good thing about it, is it really doesn't smell.
Relatively low odor.
Yeah. Okay. I'm sorry. Alright. So I think we need some heat, right?
Yeah. Let's go on speed. Or do you want me to heat it and
you talk about it? You heat out to teamwork here.
That's one of the great things about resin, though, in my opinion, is you can heat a spot and that'll move, and other spots that have been sitting longer won't adjust.
Right. Yeah, that's good.
Get anywhere close to heating your fingers up.
Perfect. Alright.
Done?
Yeah. What do we think? Okay. And we've got some spots here.
Yeah. I'm just filling in here.
Yeah, go for it.
Dip it.
Okay, okay, we're back. Okay, Janet, I did not see your question about the powder and the resin. Can you read the question again? Because I missed it, I'm so sorry.
Another good thing about having like a reliable moderator is that they can help you answer questions if like you're looking down.
Yeah, I think people will learn the answers too. Like my dad would have no idea what to say. So Dad, you gotta come paint with me. So you can learn all the answers.
Is he out in California as well?
Yeah, he lives down the street.
That's convenient.
Totally. By using the loader, I'd actually move the resin to heat the resin. Mostly in this case, mostly to heat it so that we can move it.
Mm-hmm.
Where it's not moving the resin so much itself as we're heating it. So right now we have a couple little like pock marks, so we're kind of filling those in. Well, she is. I wouldn't even know that trick.
I just pick up a similar color since I'm out in these cups.
Yeah.
And filling in.
Cool.
The thing about, this is not a blow dryer, this is a heat gun. And you can use a blow dryer, but thing about it, a blow dryer is it moves a lot of air, and you don't really want that in a lot of cases. You just want it to heat up the resin, not move the resin. You know what I mean? Like, if I brought a blow dryer out, it pushes air.
Yeah, exactly. That's a good question. I think you would want to mix it in the resin, but we'll ask Erica. So Janet was asking if she were to put resin on something and then put glow in the dark powder on top of that. I'm assuming, well, the resin's still wet.
Yeah.
Rather than mixing it in, would that work? Or is it better to just mix it in?
There are a lot of times that you can just, like this piece, I put powder on over it. I don't know if you can see the like gold powder, like where I'm showing you.
But oh, I can totally see it. Yeah, the shimmer.
That's from blowing powder over it.
Is that like mica or?
It's just, yeah, it's jacquard.
But it's like the same colors, isn't it?
Right?
They're twins.
Twinsies. But in terms of glow in the dark, I don't know that it would be a thick enough
powder
to make a difference. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I guess it would depend on what you're using. What
right.
product you're using, because there's glow in the dark everything. All kinds of different products. So
I have a glow in the dark that's really bananas.
There you go. She'll show you what's good to use.
This is my go-to for glow in the dark powders. It charges.
Ooh. Cool.
Yeah, like.
Oh, that's so awesome.
And so now that'll be lit up for a little bit. And it comes in a number of colors.
Oh, good. That's what she has.
That's what she has.
Martin Glow. Okay.
Martin Glow is great for.
With that, you would recommend just mixing it into the resin?
I would mix it in. And not only mix it in, but like worry that you mix too much in.
Okay.
Like. It takes a lot more pigment.
Also, the powders work better than, like, the paste.
Cool. All right. Well, that's been exciting. Okay.
Now, when you're using resin, if you don't have enough resin to cover it, you're more likely to get pitting. So you kind of just have to baby it just a little bit.
Yeah, that's okay. You know, it's all part of the process, experimenting.
Yes, this looks super spacey. All right, let me get a shelf.
Cool.
And then we can just answer questions for a minute if someone wants to, or like people have questions that we missed.
Like a Q&A session?
Yeah.
Ta-da!
Well, there you go. Yes, Janet, I would love to see that.
Whoever purchased that piece from you, I'll finish it up, and you can just pay me whatever the shipping is.
Yeah.
And I'll just ship it straight to them. That way, we don't have to like package it and ship it too many times.
Yeah. So kind of a question on the blow dryer here.
Mm-hmm.
Someone said maybe not use a blow dryer because it moves it too fast and you'll get more pitting. But I think that depends on your settings, right?
Right.
So I think if you were to use it on a low setting, because I've used it multiple times, a hair dryer, and I haven't really had issues with that. So I think it just depends on the settings that your hair dryer has.
Right.
But heat gun overall definitely better because it's less force and it's just heating it up.
Exactly. I personally would use a heat gun a blow dryer if I just wanted to move resin around a lot, but I would still use a heat gun or a torch to pop bubbles because...
Yes. I was dancing. My guys. Oh, they wanted to see it. You didn't show your guys a close-up?
Oh, sorry, y'all.
Oh, man.
I failed.
Hold on.
Okay,
she's gonna show
BRB.
No, just missed everything, that's all. Just kidding. I got my heat gun is Ranger, but where did you get your heat gun?
Mine's a Wagner, and I got it off, Home Depot, out of Home Depot for, $20.
There you go.
I'm going to have to baby this one a little bit because the paint was thin. I mean, we didn't have that much resin left, but.
There we go. Cool. Super spacey, guys. I like it. Find the hair dryer doesn't heat the resin up enough. That could definitely be true.
Oh my goodness, I actually tried a ring pour last night and then I got over it and did this to it.
Oh, Wife Life 93, not the heat gun. I got the torch at Walmart, but not the heat gun. Yeah, my heat gun is Ranger and then hers she got at Home Depot. This is a torch. There's many different torches. So this is the one I just got that my roommate just got me and then broke a week later. And then apparently he just bought me a new one. And then this is the heavy duty torch.
Yeah, we use the bigger one for
serious
like,
business.
When we do countertops and things like that, we use the heavier duty torches.
Yeah. So with the live feed after it's done, you can go back to any point, right?
Yes, it'll post a regular video.
Yeah, so Catherine, it'll be a regular video. You can go back and you can see the finished piece again.
Yeah.
Where can I get cheap wooden old stuff to do practice pours on? You need to make friends with someone in the construction business.
Right. I have a friend named Greg who does, he builds pours.
Yeah, that's not one. My whole family is in construction.
Oh, jealous.
I got lots of wood hanging around, plus endless saw blades.
Oh, I'm really working towards it, that's what she said.
I love to pour on saw blades, yes. I skip right over that wood comment. But Em, I would just practice on anything that you can get your hands on. Are we gonna pour again? Oh, okay, she's getting out the hex. Yeah, the triangle, that's what he just said.
Yeah, he does all shapes and sizes. He brought this one over just recently. And this one, I haven't poured on this one yet because I don't wanna waste it and I don't know what I wanna make it be.
Oh crap, how do I do this again? How do I resume it?
Go to the live.
Yeah. No. Is that the back wrong one? Oh.
There you go.
And then flip it.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, sorry guys.
Internet in my building is just poopy.
I blame the internet in her building. But if I go live in LA, it'll be fine. Anyways.
So okay. These are boards that he's built for me to try out. I haven't tried them yet because I don't know what I'm going to do on them. He does birch and I can't remember the other one.
These lip paintings, some of that thing right there on wood. Those are canvas, right?
Oh yeah, those are canvas.
Yeah, those are canvas. Cool. And I'll put all of the artists till death links in the description as well. So,
even though everybody in my feed knows who you are, I'm gonna do the same for your channel.
Okay, so do you wanna just do a Q&A session?
Yeah, if you guys have any questions, we're here
to answer them.
Yeah.
Because we couldn't, like, get to it earlier.
And I do apologize, guys. I would love to sand paint all night, but I literally have been driving for 2 days.
Y'all, she drove from L.A. to Texas.
Well, I went from L.A. to Vegas to the Grand... I went and saw the Grand Canyon yesterday, and then I drove to Texas.
Did you zip line into the Grand Canyon?
I didn't. I wanted to, but I didn't. But next time.
Maybe on your way back through, you can, like... Well, that's probably way out of the way. Now that I think about it. To go back through the Grand Canyon?
It just depends on the route you're taking, but yeah, it's kind of out of the way. I think it's probably more direct. We'll probably just direct back to L.A. But so tonight's my only night to actually get sleep.
Yeah.
Not in the car. So
restful sleep.
Are resin pours on canvas or boards? You can do either. The two that we just did were on canvases. I think the boards are, I think, better, right, if you're going to be doing, like, multiple layers.
Yeah, if it's going to get heavy on you.
If it's going to get heavy. And
definitely want to look into getting boards. But if you prep your canvas properly, it will least likely dip in the middle.
Go visit you in Iowa. I feel like that is slightly out of the way of Los Angeles. I'm going to get the one I did so we can show them the one you're going to resin.
Oh, yeah. Y'all, I'm doing a collaboration, and she did a tree ring pour, and I'm going to do my best to add to it and make it something amazing.
And this is on wood, guys. I get these wood panels generally from Blix. You can order online, or if you have a store nearby, you can.
This looks so great. It doesn't look okay. When I would do my acrylic pours, it would be just mounds of paint. Like, it looks like this, like, it's so flawless. Like, if I bring that one over there that I scraped off, it has more paint on it, I think, than this, and I scraped it completely off.
Yeah, it is important to get the right consistency. That's really the hardest part, and sometimes that can take months to get it down or whatever, you know. But if you're persistent. Okay, so there's a good question. Two questions. Gary, I think you missed it earlier, but what type of resin? So we used art resin. There are different kinds of resin you can use. But we used art resin. And then Kimberly asked proper canvas prep. So for the resin, what she did is she painted it and then sanded it.
Yes.
So if you want to tell them about that, that's a good question.
I actually have a tutorial on my channel about the process, the entire process. And so basically, I'll paint it with like flat white house paint, sand it, let it dry, or hit it with a heat gun, and then sand it down, and that will help tighten the canvas. You can also just spritz the back of the canvas with like warm water.
To tighten it up,
yeah.
To tighten it up.
That's one of those phrases.
Damn it.
Okay, so neither of us can see comments.
I know. I don't understand.
Gary, thank you. I did get that comment, and you just said it was good. So. Okay, well, mine's coming back. The feed's still good. So go ahead and keep hitting us with your... Okay, good. So I'm good with Gary's questions. Okay. Keep hitting us with your questions. We don't have Erica's feedback up quite yet. Okay, portions. Okay, art resin. Well, it's going to depend on the resin you use, but art resin is one-to-one. So you have hardener and then resin. And then anything that you mix in, you're going to want to do 10 to 1. So 10 resin, and then 1 what you're mixing in. And that you might want to be a little flexible with depending on what it is.
Mm-hmm.
So.
That piece would be an awesome geode. I'm scared.
Does Greg have a website?
Greg has an Etsy. Okay. It's ABG Designs.
Oh, Gary, yes, Blix does have art resin. Good Good night, Catherine. And Kimberly said she'll check out that tutorial on the prepping. So, yeah.
I will send you the link to that if you want to, like, add it as a card.
Yes.
Like a pop-up.
Okay, yeah, I can add it as a card in the video later.
So many, that's what she says. Yeah. Why do you paint the side of the canvas? I usually paint the sides a solid color because it just looks better when the paint, like, gaps a little bit, like this. And while I appreciate it being organic, like the drips, like this, I mean, not these, but this. It looks better if, like, I'm using a lot of black here that the side matches.
Yeah.
So, that's what that is.
Someone said, oh, Tara said she likes the sparkles on the painting.
Oh, my dude?
Yeah, there's a couple here. These are very intense.
They are intense. They took
layers.
This one just sold, actually.
Okay, cool. It seemed very heavy.
That one was super heavy.
They can double as a weapon.
They can. You can use it as a ninja star.
Hey, Jordan and Jessica Unite. Cool.
Oh, yeah. TWSS, if that's what she said. Ah. So, if you... Are you guys... like, good on the questions? Sad face, I missed all the arts. I'll post it. As soon as we're done with the feed, I'll post it.
There you go, yeah. I mean, you can always go into the comments, too, and ask questions later.
Yes.
So
if we missed any, just ask them in the comments. E, did you use puff paint to separate the resin on your geode? I did not use puff paint. What I did with the puff paint was on the outside, right here, that's where I used the puff paint just to create like an actual line that separates the geode from the crazy. I don't know how to like crazy. It is. It's like geode bananas.
Yeah.
But that's where I use the puff paint.
The textured,
yeah,
raised portions.
Cool. Right.
And you have videos on this as well?
This was the live feed from like 2 days ago.
Yeah.
I'm gonna post the time lapse of the other one probably tonight. I have nothing to do, I'm home alone.
Cool. Okay. And then ventilation, that's always a good question, Gary. Honestly, it depends on the kind of resin you're doing, but I think, yes, you should always have at least a nice wide open space and some airflow. You're not going to want to do it like in a closet or, you know,
right,
a tiny space. And art resin particularly is very good for if you have to do it inside. I always just like to read off the bottle. So it has no VOCs, no BPA. So just the odor and toxicity factors are much, much lower than on most other resins. So
yeah, I have some down here that are like, you open it and you're like, I may die today. I need to have like a hazmat. Christina, I haven't been on my Facebook today, but tonight's going to be the night that I go through everything. Good night, Lisa. I said bye, Ocean. Kelly, no, we're not going to do any more pours. She taught me how to do an acrylic tree ring pour. And I know I can't do another pour because she just drove in from L.A. She's like, I'm over the day. She needs to get some rest because aren't you, like, crying face? House. Aren't you like getting up and like hitting the road again? Like,
yeah,
tomorrow?
I got up in the morning and drive back to LA.
turnaround. I can't even.
It's like 20 some odd hour drive. That's obviously you need to like eat food and stuff too. And I I brought my poor daughter with me.
Right, you made her suffer it.
Yeah, I made her suffer.
No,
she wanted to, and she missed 2 days of school, so she's like, we're gonna party.
Right, turn up. Like, born free.
Yeah, it was a good little mother-daughter trip.
Right? Everybody's like, you drove?
I drove, yeah, because I'm crazy like that.
Poor when she goes to bed. I might come back on and do a pour later tonight. Well, who knows? Make sure you click the bell so you get the notifications.
Yeah.
People are like, it's still early, though, because they're used to my videos going, like,
it's super late. Okay. Well, do you want to do another pour?
We can do another pour.
That's fast.
Oh, an acrylic one?
Yeah, if you want.
I'm down. We have that other, canvas prepped. We prepped two.
Oh, yeah,
ones.
We did.
Y'all.
And we could do flip cup instead of.
Okay.
If you want. Yeah.
All right. Your crying has. We've heard your cries. Okay.
So give us just a second of prep here.
Reboot.
Alright. It's only like 10 p.m., you know.
Who needs sleep?
Well,
no, what is sleep?
Technically LA time, so it's only really 7.
I did these coasters on like last night.
3 p.m. Ooh, nice. Yeah, so you can also do that with extra paint left over, and then you could resin it.
These are so great. I got these for like $14 for a stack of 100.
Yeah, I saw on Amazon, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so they don't warp when you pour.
That is really awesome. I've done tile coasters before.
Yeah.
But then you gotta do all kinds of stuff with the back and the sides and sanding and whatever. I guess you have to do that too.
Well, since I lay them flat on these sheets, I don't get the base of it. And so then, actually,
do we
want to
clean that?
No, I'm just gonna put some wax paper down.
Okay. Yeah, we're gonna. So we don't resin the pan to the table.
I just don't know what happened.
Kimberly, not going anywhere. Yeah, rainbow pour. You want to do a rainbow pour? I like to do some rainbows. Good night, Gray.
That's who does my canvas pour.
Yeah.
He's a good guy.
Yeah, Greg and I will have to get in touch.
So, what's great about what Greg does is if you're like, I'm really interested in a specific shape.
Yeah, which is good because I want to
And this is my last board too. Like, I tried to do a tree ring and then it was like, so I just added those.
I like.
It looks like a cartoon character. And then I decided I'm just going to sign it in resin and then it went.
I like it.
Struggles.
So,
that's varnish to seal the coasters. Well, the resin coasters, you don't need to seal it because resin seals itself. If you're doing an acrylic pour on a coaster, you can seal it with resin. You can also seal it with
polycrylic. If resin makes you nervous, this is a good like supplement.
Yeah. And this is water-based, mm-hmm. Just to be very clear, there's oil-based and water-based. You do not want the oil-based. Is it all yellow, right? I don't know.
Several
of them will yellow,
stuff, for sure.
And whatnot. You gotta make sure you get the right one. Ooh. Okay. What were those things called you just had as coasters? Oh, they're just little wood.
They're not. They're compressed paper.
Oh.
Right? Even more.
Ink, Fish and Co. 4-inch round. Can y'all see that?
I'll send her a link.
Yeah, we'll put the link in the description as well.
Does Greg sell wood? That's what she asked. I don't know. But he just left the room, so.
Greg has left the room. I did actually.
Wood is heavier, but I think
don't go to bed.
I think that they both end up pretty heavy because of the resin. Do you seal the coasters before you pour the resin? Nicole, I do not seal the coasters at all. I will seal the back of it with a polyacrylate just so that, like, for condensation and stuff like that, it doesn't stuff. You know what I'm saying?
Kimberly, that we were talking about sealing coasters that you do an acrylic pour on. That's what we were talking about. Okay.
Everybody's like, two of my favorite pour people coming together. I'm gonna have I'm making shirts that says I'm a pour artist, but like P-O-U-R. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, shout out to someone who I thought has the best IG name is Acrylic Porn, but P-O-U-R.
Oh my goodness. That's amazing. Can I be resin porn now?
Yeah.
Anyways, resin porn. This is what the one from last night looked like.
That's awesome.
It's like that pink is a powder, so it's like got that weird metallic iridescent to it. So I was pretty happy with it. When I poured it, I was like, this is going to be a nightmare. It is not going to work out like I wanted to. But it did.
No, that's awesome.
It's amazing what you can do in one night. Like, I poured this one, like, basically the same night, and it looked like this. So, like, redemption. I need a redemption.
Okay. What do we want to do here?
People are like, flip cup.
I'm down.
What's the best resin for a beginner to use? They're nervous. Penny, I would suggest using, depends on your budget. Art resin's amazing, but if you're tight on funds, it is not the best because it's one of the most expensive. But as a beginner, you want the most open time you can get because 30, 45 minutes comes real quick when you're like first starting.
Yeah, and I'm a beginner and I found the art resin super easy to use. Yeah. Like, you know, my first piece I was super happy with, you know, so I think, I mean, that's my 2 cents on it, but I'm a beginner. Erica's had a lot more. But how long does it take the acrylic pour to dry? Generally about 2 days. So also longer than resin. Resin takes about 24 hours.
Yeah. You could touch it after 12.
Yeah.
I have a question. I've done an acrylic pour on a record. How do I have to wait to resin? No silicone and thin paint. So how long after an acrylic pour, if you don't have silicone and the paint is thinner?
This is a very varied answer for different people. Honestly, my answer would be probably about 4 to 7 days. I've done it within just like a few days if it's really thin and it dries within a day and whatnot. Some people wait like a whole month. I think that's a little overkill.
I think that's excessive.
I think that's extremely overkill.
Like, once the water is evaporated,
yeah,
it's not going to get any drier.
Yeah, so I'd say maybe about 4 days should be totally fine.
Mm-hmm.
So,
Envirotex is a good resin to start with. It's easily accessible. You can get it at Michael's. You can use the half off coupon and you'll get 32 ounces for about $20.
Chris, this is 12 by 24 canvas, guys. Offline. Oh no. Balls. Why is it so? Resume. Reconnecting. Flip. Okay. We're back on.
Says Judy says 3 weeks and Marcy says 3 to 4 weeks to cure. Apparently, it's not about being dry, it's about it curing to the canvas.
Yes, but we're also talking about a record here. It's not a canvas.
Oh, yeah.
It's a record. So I'd say just a few days is fine. Canvas, yeah, you probably want to wait a little bit longer. And it is going to depend on how thick your paint is and everything as well. So.
Right. See, I didn't even know that because, okay, before the tree ring pour that I did tonight with you, this is my best pour. Please hold.
I think it's awesome.
So, all right, I'm going to prep my cup here.
Okay.
So, you are going to do, I don't know, maybe we should do a rainbow one.
Mm. Boom.
I think it's awesome.
I did it and it was horrible.
It's like accidental swipe is what that is.
Like, see this funky gray color? That's what it all looked like on the top. So I was like, I'm over it. And then I was like, wait a minute.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm not over it. But wait, there's more. Again. It's crazy that it's doing that, but your feed is still like.
Yeah.
I see you.
There we go. Okay.
All right. We're back. Okay. So.
Sorry, guys.
You run the risk of having your piece cloud when the moisture is trying to evaporate and can't get out because of the resin. Well put, Judy.
Yes.
Jeff. I know, Christina, I gave it my all, and it was not enough. Honestly, 2B. Okay, these aren't teal. They're, like, I just left the liner on so that, because my resin pops right off of this, so, like, it's not teal, but the liner is teal because genius. Also, Amazon.
Okay, I am back again, everybody, right? Song I have made is I have a billion bunch of coconuts. Okay.
Coconuts?
I don't know.
Oh, okay, are you starting with like darker colors?
Yeah, I'm going dark on this.
So do you want to go opposite or do you want to go match?
I tend to lean towards. I don't know.
Okay.
What do you have a leaning towards?
No.
No?
I lean towards wing it.
Wing it?
That's totally up to you. My general.
I started with zinc.
Just straight out of the bottle?
No, this is pre-mixed. I mixed up too much, so I'll put it back in the bottle. This is a really cool metallic. It's like silver, but like a darker.
So it's like a pewter-ish.
Almost. Yeah. And then black, purple, blue. I'm kind of going all over the place with this, but I think it's going to be awesome. Definitely on the darker side. Thank you, Ideas Born. Cup.
No, we're not doing a dirty pour. We're doing a flip cup. I'm oppositing.
It is a dirty pour.
Oh, I thought you were.
Do you know what a dirty pour is?
Yeah. Isn't that where you like just put it all in there and then pour it?
No.
Okay, there's two.
I fail. Basically, there's a clean pour and a dirty pour. A clean pour, you're going to pour each color individually on the canvas. A dirty pour, you're going to pour all the colors in a cup, and then you're going to put it on the canvas one way or another. Either okay. You can flip it, you can tree ring it, you can just do a design. All of those are still a dirty pour.
I see.
Yeah.
Okay, so when I first started, I thought that a dirty pour was... Like, if you put it all in the cup and then you pour it out. And then a flip cup is specifically flip cup. Like,
yeah.
I've never even heard of a dirty versus clean pour.
Yeah, so I'm going to kind of use the rest of that.
No worries.
I like blue. Someone commented once, like, I always say a little more blue and then I pour like half the bottle.
That's a little bit all of
just
it.
Just a little bit more. Pink. Well, I did pour red in here. I'm not a huge pink fan, but you can do pink.
No more white. Okay.
Yeah.
I was just trying to, like, that's so fun looking. Okay. I'm over gloating in the cup.
Down here. It's like a delay.
Yeah.
Sign here. Can you see that? Yeah, there we go. That's cool.
Okay.
I'll show everybody mine. Show me yours.
Sorry.
You're gonna turn into...
Yeah, I'm horrible.
An ATD After Dark type person.
Show you guys mine. Okay. I think I showed everybody. I don't know. Okay. Yeah, so she's gonna get pink. So, for all y'all that like pink, that's gonna be in her cup.
You're welcome.
Yeah, you're welcome.
I love when it like bubbles back up. That's my favorite part.
Yeah. Yep. Ideas born said, E, you're doing an acrylic pour. Yes, she is.
Don't judge me.
Purple Peter, people eater. Gary, you're so funny.
I still don't have as much as you do.
No, you don't. Yeah, that's, I'd say one, there's two common mistakes beginners make in pouring. One is paint too thick. And the second one is not using quite enough paint.
So, I'm still too low. Or no?
You're gonna get some black.
Oh.
No. You wanna do the light versus dark, don't you?
Doesn't matter.
What did you put in there already?
I used blue, and white, and purple, and red.
Okay.
And a little bit of gold. And now some blue.
Yeah.
Those colors go together.
Okay, let's just fill yours up a little bit more. Okay. Yeah, you definitely got pink. All right, I think we're good. So.
Shut up. That's such a neon pink. I didn't think that would happen. Yeah. With, like, all the...
All right, we're going to attempt. Please hold. Wait. I'm off the line.
Open up again. Okay, luckily I didn't start the flip cup yet. Would suck. Mm-hmm. Resume. Okay. There we go. Okay. Sorry, guys.
I'm so sorry.
All right. Are we gonna like put the canvas on it and then put it back over, or are you?
Well,
like,
there's two ways.
Quick draw McGraw about it.
Oh, I just. Yeah.
Oh my God. Okay, you guys.
You got this.
I don't know if I got it. Either I'm gonna like smash it through the canvas, or all the paint's gonna end up on the laptop.
Okay. Don't smash it through the canvas.
I'm scared. Ready?
Okay,
there you go.
Okay.
Nailed it so far.
Crushed it.
Complete crushage.
Okay, good. So I'm going to move all these bottles real quick while we let the paint like
settle
for a second. And then...
Get your base ready.
Because you know I'm not
fair, not paying attention to color theory. I'm sorry, Anita. I'm going to get a mic that's next on my investments.
You did. Okay.
We keep going, make sure I'm back on.
Yeah, still online. Okay, good. All right, you ready, Freddy?
I don't know.
No, maybe?
Hold on, let me reload.
Just going to double check to make sure you're...
I know. I think your charger battery's good.
Yeah. Hey, you're good.
Alright, I got a little overexcited.
So I've seen people like surround it. Have you ever done that, like drag the?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can. We have way more than enough paint for that, though. With too much paint?
Gotcha.
Yeah, for that you would want to use a smaller little cup of paint.
Understood. So you're letting like a little bit out at a time. Is there like a specific...
Nope. Kind of whatever you want.
That is just awesome together. I love that fade.
Yeah. And then here, does this thing work? Or is it just for looks?
That is just for looks. You're going to use the big one. It's resined together. Like...
Okay.
Where did I put the big torch?
Oh, it's down there. Okay. All right. I have not used one of these in a long time, and I generally only use it for campfires.
Do you want me to do it?
Yeah. That's all I want. You know what? What she's doing, Dad, that she's on her Wi-Fi and I'm not. So I should have gotten onto her Wi-Fi. So I'm sorry, guys.
Why? This is like intense.
No,
okay, maybe we skip torching.
We're gonna burn it this thing.
Well, there we go.
Yay, blonde Lebanese! You're here! Hey, Annie.
Oh, look at that. Yours is already killing
me right now.
Okay. This torch is a little intimidating.
I'm turning it down.
Size, I think, doesn't matter. Okay. I may light the canvas on fire, guys.
It'll be fine. I've got a fire extinguisher.
All right, that's more than
you beat me again.
Okay, yeah, you got it. Cool. All right.
Missy, I don't use blue anymore. Are we still live? Yes, we sure are.
Yeah.
Hey, ideas. He's just jumping back and forth.
This is a little off. You know what? You get to tilt this.
If you let me tilt it, this is going to happen. I'm going to tilt my part all the way off because I'm not going to mess up your canvas with my colors. All
right. So we can do, I'm going to just show you real quick. You can do the same thing you do with the resin.
Okay.
And bring these out to the edge.
It flows so much easier than.
Yeah. Okay. It's not half as sticky as the resin. So. Especially when I don't want to lose too many parts. I'd like to do this because it'll help the paint flow better as you're tilting. You just destroy a bit less of your masterpiece. Yeah, that's kind of cool. That's funky.
Nurse calls, you are going to get addicted. I always warn people that acrylic pouring is the gateway drug. Resin pouring. That's bananas, dude.
Mm-hmm.
I need some of the secret sauce in your like pouring medium.
Okay, I'm just
hi, Justine.
Fast, guys.
Oops. You're good.
I'm gonna paint you.
Floytrol and distilled water. Does distilled water versus regular matter?
That's a good question. I actually used distilled for a while, and I noticed zero difference whatsoever.
Okay, so that's falling off is better than my part on.
To tap water.
It looks like awesome, and then blown up, like when it's like out of focus, like really zoomed in on something.
See, so I did stretch this a little more than I wanted to, but that's okay. I think
I'm not mad at this being blown up.
Yeah, no. When we got a bit of the light versus dark, I like your half better.
I really like how like those red cells pop through.
Yeah, and you get it can sit there for a while, and more will happen. You can also torch it after, and more can happen.
Nervous? You're running away from me.
Yeah.
Run!
I'm gonna go over here. So. I don't get lit on fire.
You just went like into the stream of fire as you were avoiding it.
Well, but I noticed the part over here that needed fixing.
Now, you don't use silicone or...
That's a negative.
No! I'm really excited about this. Like, I love how it continues over the edge.
Yeah, it's a continuation. Yeah, I mean, you totally can use silicone, and I think it's good when you're first starting with acrylic pouring to use silicone, because it will definitely help you get cells. But after you get your mixture right, it kind of just adds another step, because then you got to clean it properly in order to seal it. And if you don't clean it and you go ahead and seal it, it won't work.
Okay.
Been there, done that. The sealing, whatever you're using, it doesn't matter what it is,
whether it's
resin or whatever, it won't stick. You know, so you'll have to clean it. Plus, I feel like it gives you a little bit less control
I would agree.
Over your cells. Like, sometimes you can get psycho crazy cells all over the place when you didn't want to, and, you know, it just, I think it's a little bit less control on it.
Agreed. I used Resiglas on this, and I feel like that's kind of the same, like, it just goes retarded a little bit.
I think it's good.
So, like, right here, it's got, like, residue still.
Oh, yeah, I see that.
I used 2 drops.
Wow. Okay, yeah. That's interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's like silicone, but for resin, is the Resi Blast, guys.
Yeah.
For any of you that don't know. Tubular.
Ta-da!
Yeah, there we go. All right. You asked, we answered. Edward said that thing is still oozing.
Yes!
Yes.
God, yes.
Can you use alcohol?
Are you asking if we use alcohol in...
in the pores or drinking while pouring?
Right. Are you talking about, like, as a sippy-sippy?
No.
Or in acrylic pores or in... something, resin pores.
Yes. Well, I can answer for acrylic pores. I can't answer for resin, but for acrylic pores, I do have several videos with alcohol, one specifically that shows 2 different ways that you can use, that you can use alcohol in acrylic pores.
Oh, it is alcohol in acrylic.
Yeah, so if you go to my videos, there's one literally called 2 ways you can use alcohol in acrylic pores besides drinking it. That's what it's called.
Perfect.
So one is, like, you can actually mix it in with the paint, or you can also use it afterwards, spray it on top and whatnot to help create cells and other funky things.
Come here. I'm going to say hi.
Okay, the puppy's going to come say hi real quick.
Come here.
This is Cujo.
You will like every part of the face.
And I'm trying not to paint you.
Yeah. I know, I'm gonna need a baby powder that was oozing. Everybody's like, no! It's so new!
Nip up, everybody loves to see you.
Yeah.
Did you say hi to everybody? Did you say hi? You did. Yeah? My new best friend.
No.
All right, guys, yeah. I do have to sign off. So,
she's got to drive tomorrow.
Yeah, I got to get some sleep. I'm very excited to actually sleep in a bit today.
Right. He's a Pomeranian.
Yeah.
Sorry. Totally interrupted.
Didn't see sharp teeth.
He's ferocious.
That's the hilarious part, you know. It's the Napoleon complex.
Everybody's saying... drive safe, sleep well.
I will. Thank you, guys. All right, and we'll arrange somehow, some way, doing this again.
Yes.
I plan to, in the next few, rest of my life, do a lot of traveling. The next few, rest of my life.
Right.
So I will likely be up in Canada soon, in New York. Yeah, I kind of have a lot of... we're going all over the place, and if anyone wants to come to LA and visit me,
we'll come out to LA.
You totally can.
We'll bring them.
And we'll go ahead and paint together.
Right.
All right, good night, y'all. Good night, Dad.
All right, and feed. All right, you guys. We'll see y'all tomorrow. Bye. I said bye.